Good morning, everyone. A brisk morning out here at Churchill Downs. We are live in Louisville, and it is Derby Day.
And a tense scene for more than 4 hours in downtown Lexington overnight.
That program is called Canopies for Kids, and it's a great way for all of you daredevils out there to give back.
A man was sent to the hospital after coming face to face with two robbers inside his motel room. Troopers say a speeding SUV ran a red light and smashed into a car and then a semi. The student behind an anonymous Twitter feed in Boyle County, which spreads positive messages about students and staff, was finally outed at Sunday's graduation.
And back to the fans. Of course, I think we've made it clear by now that you don't have to be from Lexington to be a Cats fan.
All eyes still on California Chrome as he attempts to become the first horse in 36 years to win the coveted Triple Crown. Manager said Putins are actually very popular and sell for about $6 a piece.
I think I'm with Tom. Anything called a Putin, I ain't eating it.
Anything made of chocolate, it. I will eat it.
You're going for it.
Lexington police described a man missing for a week as a danger to himself and others. And now with a copy of a letter that he allegedly wrote, we know a little bit more as to why. LEX 18 obtained a copy of the overly graphic letter that James Caldwell is accused of leaving. A black bear in Florida found a rather cozy place to catch a few Z's last week. Take a look. He is in a hammock. He hopped in, and as you can see, he just made himself comfortable. As exciting as it was for the neighborhood to see that photo, residents say they don't want him back. The hammock has since been taken down, and residents say they now plan to be more careful with their garbage.
Julie Dolan is in true blue Indianapolis.
Lower level tickets for tomorrow night's big game are selling from anywhere from $1,800 to $5,000 online. Now, if you're buying from an accredited website, you're probably safe. But if you're buying outside on the streets here at Lucas Oil Stadium, it's buyer beware.
High profile murder case here in Lexington. Marty Rowe, facing trial for the murder of Dr. Martha Post, has written several letters to the judge in the case saying he wants out of jail and to help find the real killer. Dr. Post was shot and killed outside her office back in September 2011.
Now that's expected to set the local Salvation Army back about $60,000.
Oh, wow.
So they're really hoping that you can help out. And many of us here at LEX 18 are doing our best to help out. I was at the mall this weekend.
A television the size of three NBA courts. That's how big, it's bigger than that.
When you said that this morning, oh, that's unbelievable. It is big. And no matter where you're sitting here at Churchill, it makes a big difference for the spectator. LEX 18's Josh Breslow caught up with some of those construction workers and he found out what else they're working on.
Hey, so I was watching a TV show the other day, a talk show, and they started talking about the World Series, and I actually thought I was watching a rerun because I thought, surely it's not time for the World Series, right? But it is.
How long would you have to stay underground?
Who would go up to check?
Yeah. Is it?
I nominate you.
Can we come out? Are we okay?
I don't know. I guess you live there forever.
Yeah.
It was a case of the right place, the right time, and the right people that helped a Florida man get a long-awaited kidney transplant. Get this. After waiting 10 years for a new kidney, Robert Barber got the call last week that doctors had finally found one. But while driving to the hospital, he got a flat tire. He called 911 for help, and when police arrived, they hit their lights and sirens and rushed him to the hospital. They only had 3 minutes to make it in time for the surgery, and they did it. Barber got the kidney he needed. Love that story.
The winning move.
That's kind of cool, but the hand doesn't look very authentic. It's just very, bendy. I didn't realize what it was doing at
first.
You
play a quick match here?
All right, I'll crush you. No! I'm so bad.
The guys are all dressed up too, and they may turn more heads than the ladies sometimes.
Yeah, you'd like to think so.
Yeah, you know, I would.
So what are some of the guys wearing at this year's Derby? Let's check in with our resident fashionista, Kristen Flum.
Word on here.
Oh, this is going to be messy.
Which she did say, have a napkin ready. That's
all
why
right,
I do.
Here we go.
All right, here we go.
Oh, it's good.
It's like molasses.
And honey.
It's one thing Kentuckians just can't get enough of, and that's why this LA plant here in Winchester pushes out 7,000 to 10,000 cases of this carbonated, caffeinated soft drink every day. And it all begins with a secret ginger-based formula perfected more than 80 years ago.
And describing it is something I always try to wrap my head around. A little bit of a citrus, a little bit of a ginger flavor. I think the only answer is to give it a try.
And we will, but first, a little history. It
was the great-great-uncle of now CEO Fielding Rogers who developed the unique soft drink in 1926. A trip to Northern Europe inspired G.L. Wainscott to work with the ginger flavor, and not long after, Ale 1 was born. The soft drink was one of many he'd create, but remains his biggest success. So, exactly how is it made? Let's take a look inside. The process begins with the classic green bottles, shipped in and ready to label.
So the line will run at a peak of about 625 bottles per minute. So if you think about that, that's a little over 10 bottles a second.
The bottles are then spun, rinsed, and dried before heading to the blending room.
This is really where Ale 8 is made.
The Ale 8 concentrate is blended, then pumped next door where it's mixed with water, carbonated, chilled, and ready to drink right off the line. Most ingredients are in plain sight, but it's what's inside these buckets Rogers won't say a word about. He does admit it's potent. One drop of the secret formula can make 16 bottles and one bucket, 2,500 cases. It's so strong, Rogers only has to mix it up 3 to 4 times a year using Wainscott's original handwritten recipe. And when he does, no one else is around. So where is that original recipe kept, and where does the mixing process happen?
It's all a secret, but yeah, we take it very seriously. The only people alive today who've ever made it are the family members who've been doing it for generations now.
And that's not us. So the next obvious step would be to compare the ingredient labels. Let's compare an L81 to your average ginger ale.
The only listed differences are the use of artificial flavors, phosphoric acid, and caffeine in L81. No luck here either. It appears the secrets lie within the unlisted natural flavors. Bottom line,
it is the taste that brings people back to it.
And it's one we'll have to keep tasting to figure out. Covering the news in Winchester, Julie Dolan, LEX 18 News.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you all?
Good.
Good. You want a teddy bear?
Yay.
I want a teddy bear.
You know what that teddy bear did? It jumped out of an airplane with me.
It's all smiles for 6-year-old Isabel, a patient at Kentucky Children's Hospital, who was given one of the first bears to go skydiving with Pro Troy Woods. Thanks to a program called Canopies for Kids, the bears are taken on a jump and given out to kids in hospitals to offer comfort and encourage bravery.
Would you like to see a picture of it? Let me get a picture.
But we've got more than pictures. We took our own crew out to the jump zone in Lebanon so I could take a bear on a special jump. Jump for Fun owner and tandem instructor Bill Harden says when Woods introduced him to Canopies for Kids,
rock right up on your feet.
He was excited to be the first in Kentucky to offer it.
Oh, okay.
Think hips forward, but
first some instructions, okay. Then practice.
Ready, set, and you dive right at his foot.
Well, maybe not quite ready, but once right. I suited up and had the bear strapped on, we were ready for takeoff. Once the plane reached an altitude of 10,000 feet, we launched, flying at speeds of up to 120 miles per hour. At 5,500 feet, the chute's deployed, and the rest is smooth sailing. A slightly bumpy landing for our tandem jump, but an overall success for the bear.
And what's that strap do you?
It's pretty awesome to see the first bear land and see you filling out the card and everything, and I can't wait to take it to the hospital.
And that's exactly what he did with more than 80 bears in tow.
Hello. Would you like a bear?
This really just, it like suits him. He is one of the bravest little boys that I know.
As for Isabel, her mom says it's life-changing.
I'm just trying not to cry because I just think it's really beautiful. It really, it just, she's delighted, and it's the first really big smile I've seen on her face in a few days.
And it's those smiles and the hope they bring that makes it all worth it for Woods.
It's humbling. It's a great feeling. I can't wait to do more.
For this edition of Making a Difference, I'm Julie Dolan. Hard to watch, especially if it's your own.
He fell down the whole set of stairs, and then, like, the next day, his feet were sort of dragging, and then we realized that happened to him.
9-year-old Cassius was diagnosed with degenerative myelopathy last fall.
We knew that the obvious next step was to get him some wheels.
It was 8-year-old Ryder, who considers the dog another brother, who decided to raise money to buy the several $100 wheelchair needed.
A minion from Despicable Me.
Selling these keychains and magnets.
This one was the simplest one.
Ryder raised $315 in a matter of days, more than enough to buy Cash his first set of wheels.
He put his feet right here.
And still getting used to the apparatus. He's just a few steps behind.
Kashi!
Hopefully this will give him a lot more freedom and mobility, and he'll be with us for a lot longer.
Mom Lissa McConathy says the old pup isn't in any pain and just as playful as ever. As she looks back at the video she took the first time he was on all fours again, she says it's hard not to get emotional.
Yay! Kashi!
Moments that wouldn't have been possible without an 8-year-old determined to make a difference.
It's just his nature. He's always trying to think of ways to help.
And now the boxer that used to run faster than anyone is rolling right alongside them. Covering the news in Lexington, Julie Dolan, LEX 18 News.
So now we're going to get you in your gear, okay?
Suiting up and practicing indoors, the easy part.
Hang.
Step down off the ladder.
Here, the first group of repellers to brave the Big Blue Building this year. It's the second annual fundraiser for the local Boy Scouts. Last year's brought in more than $100,000, and they're hoping to top that over the next 2 days. Following safety tips inside, the real fun was awaiting us outside on the 31st floor of the Fifth Third Bank Building.
Did you look over?
No, not really.
Don't look.
Instructors say going over the edge is the hardest part, but with a little bit of coaching, I made it.
Here we go.
You're doing a great job.
Okay.
And so did LEX 18 contest winner Crystal Lidecker, who rappelled right beside me.
Yay! Doing it. I knew that first step was going to be terrifying, and it was.
31 stories, 410 feet down. It was more work than we expected, and more fun, too.
It was so awesome. I'm just so grateful for the opportunity to even be able to do this. How many people can say that they've scaled the Fifth Third Building downtown Lexington? It's awesome.
And at the bottom, a minute to celebrate, regain consciousness, and issue a challenge for next year.
Lee Cruz, you're next.
Covering the news in Lexington, Julie Dolan, LEX 18 News.